One of the most important platforms in 2024 is going to be RISC-V. And MIPS is one of those companies that is taking it to the next level. So, Samir, could you tell us a little bit about the new MIPS you're focusing on RISC-V?
Thank you, Bill. So my name is Samir Vasan, and I'm the CEO at MIPS. I joined the company back in September. And since then, we've been working to put together what we're calling the new MIPS. And the new MIPS is essentially focused on getting the freedom to innovate back into the hands of our customers. RISC-V is a phenomenon which is only accelerating pace. And it's something which is, I believe, going to be a very mainstream architecture moving forward. It already is in many spaces, but I think that's only going to grow. And the reason why RISC-V is going to be successful over a period of time is because I think it gives customers control back in terms of what they want to do with their system. It is a very fine balance between letting customers innovate on their systems while making sure they don't have to carry the entire cost of re-architecting something by having it as a standard as well. So I think the RISC-V community, which we are a very proud member of and something which we will continue contributing and leading, is done a very credible job in finding that balance. And I think in 2024, I expect it to become stronger as the software ecosystem and as the tool chain starts getting even more mature. Now, coming back to the new MIPS, see, in the new MIPS, we are focused on taking the MIPSiness. And when I say MIPSiness, these are certain unique features of a MIPS core, such as hardware virtualization, multi-threaded architecture, low deterministic latency, very, very good real-time control, and take these features into markets which need it. And there are a few markets which stand out. We already have been supplying into the automotive market. So if you think about the ADAS market, the largest ADAS player is Mobileye. And in many ways, they've been using MIPS for a long time. They're on our platform moving forward as well. So if you think about it, 60 to 70% of the world's ADAS actually runs on MIPS. And we intend to continue expanding and building on that. And the reason we are good at that is, again, because our ADAS systems are becoming high-performance compute. They're getting even more complicated between multi-threaded capabilities with multiple sensors coming in, combined with hardware virtualization, where you can have multiple OSs at the same time. I think there's certain MIPS features which come in very handy. We also see a similar trend from a software-defined vehicle perspective, where zonal architectures are going to become more predominant, whether it is an EV or a traditional ICE engine, doesn't matter. I think each one of us wants our cars to integrate better with our lives, and that can only happen if software upgradability becomes easier. And I think zonal architecture is the right way to do that. So I think that will be an interesting one. And then the third one I'll highlight is basically taking MIPS back to its roots in networking, just in the modern context of cloud and hyperscalers. So if you think about the problem of CPU and GPU utilization, while we're putting a large amount of CPUs on board, many of them are not utilized anything above 50% today because they're waiting on memory. So as you think of architecture evolving from a disaggregation perspective, we are going to need very, very efficient data movement. And that is at a board level, but even at an SoC level, very, very efficient data movement, because that's where power efficiency comes in. And I think those are two problems which MIPS has been solving for many years. That was solved many years back as networking processors or Wi-Fi or DSL or cable. Today, just scale that out and make it cloud. And we're obviously scaling our technology to do that. But I think we have some very interesting engagements from a data movement in the cloud perspective, which are very interesting. 2024 is going to be an exciting year. I think we have we are relaunching the company with a renewed focus on solving some of these difficult compute problems for the customer. And I think we have a lot more exciting stuff coming through the rest of 2024.
Very, very good. One thing I wanted to sort of touch on is that while you're essentially coming out with risk support and essentially revamping the company, in terms of what's actually underneath, that is something that you have effectively been building on for a very, very long time. so that the change, you know, just an instruction set is actually a rather minor piece. And the very important part is that the actual implementation, either of the multi-threading support, the hardware virtualization, things of that nature that are essentially the same thing from what you've been doing before.
Exactly. So, I mean, we are keeping our architecture or our cores grounded in what made MIPS successful over the years. RISC-V is, it's not a very simple translation. It is a change.
Mm-hmm.
But the change is still keeping it very, very in sync with what the MIPSiness of the cores are. So to us, there are many RISC-V cores out there, and I think that will only continue expanding. But the ones which are going to be able to go focus on solving specific compute problems because their implementation solves those problems better than anything else are the ones which customers are going to gravitate towards. And I think that's our approach, where there's certain things which a MIPS core will do better than any other core on the planet. And I think that's where we want to go drive it while leveraging RISC-V as a commonality so that customers don't have to continue rewriting their software.
Very good. Well, thank you for introducing us to the new MIPS.